Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss Formoterol. What is this drug Formoterol? From the name of this drug, we can find some interesting information. We can remember few of the information in easy way. For instance, the first three letters FOR can be remembered as FOR. So this drug is having some long duration of action. So Formoterol is a long acting drug. And the suffix sterol indicates this drug belongs to a group of drugs ending with similar suffix. For instance, albuterol, which is also called as salbutamol, and salmeterol. All these drugs are having a similar suffix, terol. So these drugs are acting on the beta 2 adrenergic receptors acting on the bronchioles. So they are acting like bronchodilators. But even all these drugs are ending with similar suffix, their duration of action is not equal. Albuterol is a short-acting beta 2 agonist, so it is commonly known as SABA, short-acting beta 2 adrenergic agonist. Whereas salmeterol is classified as LABA, long-acting beta 2 adrenergic agonist. Now here, Formoterol is also a long-acting drug, which is classified as LABA. We can also remember the side effects of Formoterol from the name of this drug. Just we have seen that the prefix FOR can be remembered as FOR, so this drug is long acting beta 2 agonist. The letter M can be remembered as muscle cramps, so this drug produces some muscle cramps as one of the important side effects. And O can be remembered as hypokalemia, so potassium levels are reduced, which produce hypokalemia, resulting in the muscle cramps. The letter T can be remembered as tremor, so one of the important side effects of Formoterol is the tremor, as this drug is going to increase the muscle twitching. The letter E can be remembered as exacerbation. Even Formoterol is a bronchodilator, it can increase the bronchospasm. So on long term use, Formoterol can also increase the bronchospasm. So even it is a paradoxical effect, exacerbation of bronchospasm, particularly in the patient with COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disorder, can be observed with long term use of Formoterol. And finally, the letter R can be remembered as rapid heartbeat. So Formoterol can increase the heartbeat, resulting in the palpitations and tachycardia. In this way, we can remember few of the important side effects of Formoterol with simple quotes. M indicates muscle cramps, O indicates hypokalemia, T indicates tremor, E indicates exacerbation of bronchospasm, and R indicates rapid heartbeat. Prefix FOR indicates it is a FOR acting, so it is a long acting beta 2 agonist. Actually, the Formoterol, the prefix FORMO indicates that this is having the formamide moiety. Being a beta 2 adrenergic agonist, this drug is having some structural similarity with the catecholamines. So catecholamines are having the OH group at 3rd and 4th position of benzene ring. Now this OH group is going to be replaced with the formamide in Formoterol. Long-acting beta 2 adrenergic agonist can be combined with other category of drugs such as ICS. Just we have seen that Formoterol is a long-acting beta 2 agonist. So this can be combined with inhalation corticosteroids such as budesonide, beclomethasone, fluticasone, cyclosinide. Any of these steroids can be combined with the Formoterol and they can be formulated in different dosage forms. For instance, this combination can be prepared as inhaler. In this inhaler, both Formoterol and ICS are going to be combined, which are going to be administered into the mouth through the inhaler. Why this combination is going to be used? In this combination, Formoterol is a long-acting beta 2 agonist, so it can act on the bronchioles to produce a bronchodilation. On the other hand, inhalation corticosteroids can reduce the recurrence of bronchospasm. So in the patients with any asthma and COPD, these inhalation corticosteroids can reduce the recurrence. Thereby, they can be used as preventive medication, so they can reduce the attacks of asthma and severe bronchospasm. The Formoterol can also be combined with other category of drugs such as anticholinergics. Few of the drugs like tiotropium, glycopyrrolate, these drugs can be combined with the Formoterol and they can be given either as capsules or inhalers. All these are indicated by inhalation route. Both of these drugs are acting on the bronchioles, but in a different way. The Formoterol is going to activate the beta 2 adrenergic receptors, whereas anticholinergics are going to block the M3 receptors. So Formoterol is an agonist and anticholinergics are the antagonists. But the result is same, both of these drugs are going to produce a bronchodilation. And particularly this combination is more useful in the treatment of COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disorder, where anticholinergics show more efficacy in the treatment. Formoterol alone is also available. It is available as capsules which are taken by inhalation route by using rotahaler, which is opening the capsule where the medicament is going to be inhaled directly into the lungs. They are also available as solutions which is intended for nebulization. But nowadays Formoterol is more preferred in combination with other drugs such as inhalation corticosteroids or anticholinergics. Now let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of Formoterol. We can clearly observe that it is having the formamide moiety. So Formoterol is a formamide derivative of catecholamines. Now let us see how this drug acts. On the bronchial smooth muscle, beta 2 adrenergic receptors are present, which are G protein coupled receptors. They are coupled with alpha beta gamma subunits. Now Formoterol acts as a long acting beta 2 adrenergic agonist. This drug is having a duration of action of around 12 hours. So it can be given twice daily. And this Formoterol can stimulate these beta 2 receptors, resulting in the activation of adenylyl cyclase system. This adenylyl cyclase, when it is activated, it can convert the ATP into one of the secondary messenger, cyclic AMP. Now cyclic AMP plays an important role in the smooth muscle. In the heart, it is responsible for contraction, but within the smooth muscle, it is responsible for relaxation of the smooth muscle. This cyclic AMP can phosphorylate one of the important enzyme MLCK, myosin light chain kinases. This myosin light chain kinases are going to be converted into myosin light chain phosphate, which is the inactive form of this enzyme. In this way, the activity of MLCK is going to be reduced by cyclic AMP. This MLCK is required for phosphorylation of myosin light chains. So myosin light chain phosphates are not formed due to inactivation of MLCK. So when this myosin light chain phosphates are not formed, the contractile mechanism is inhibited, resulting in the relaxation of the smooth muscle. In this way, Formoterol acts as bronchodilator, but this drug is having long duration of action. What are the precautions? One of the important precautions is that the Formoterol should not be given for acute exacerbations of COPD. So for acute bronchospasm, this Formoterol is not that much useful. In such conditions, this drug is somewhat ineffective and it should be treated by short-acting beta 2 agonists. Similarly, this drug can stimulate the beta 2 receptors located on the smooth muscle, resulting in the increased muscle twitching, leading to tremor in the patients. Even this drug is more selective towards the beta 2 receptors. It can also act on beta 1 receptors. So Formoterol can stimulate the beta 1 receptors located on the heart, resulting in the palpitations, tachycardia, even it can produce some chest pain. So in the patients with any angina or tachycardia and other cardiovascular disorders, this drug should be carefully given. Formoterol can also reduce the serum potassium levels, resulting in the hypokalemia, which increase the muscle cramps. So again, care should be taken with other drugs which again produce hypokalemia. Similarly, this drug can increase the glucose levels, resulting in the hyperglycemia. This action may be attributed to increased glucose production within the liver by activation of beta 2 receptors. So Formoterol can produce the hyperglycemia. So in the diabetic patients, this drug should be carefully given. What are the side effects? The important side effects mainly include tremor, dizziness, insomnia, palpitations, dry mouth, some leg cramps can be observed, hypotension because it produces vasodilation, hypokalemia, hyperglycemia can be observed, and it can also produce some allergic reactions and rashes can be observed with this Formoterol. So that's about this drug Formoterol, which is a long acting beta 2 agonist. If you have the information of this drug, can be remembered in easy way. The prefix for indicates that it is a for acting, it's a having long duration of action, and it is classified as long acting beta 2 agonist. And the letter M indicates it produces muscle cramps. O can be remembered as hypokalemia. T can be remembered as tremors. E can be remembered as exacerbation of bronchospasm. R can be remembered as rapid heartbeats. So with this, we can remember the side effects and drug information of Formoterol in easy way. So that's for today. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.